My name is Darby Finley, and I'm a terrestrial biologist for Colorado Parks and Wildlife. We're flying deer classifications, also known as inventory, where we actually fly around and get a subsample of mule deer across their winter ranges and get a sex and age ratio. It's really impossible to count all the deer, so it's just kind of a random sample of deer across the landscape. It gives us a ratio or a subsample of what's actually out there for us to put in our population models. We fly around, and every group of deer that we see, we go through that group, and we classify the deer by whether it's a buck deer, whether it's a doe deer, or whether it's a mule deer fawn. This information we use to calculate a ratio. It would be the number of bucks per 100 does and the number of fawns per 100 does. And that's how what we put into our population models to estimate deer numbers. You'll hear me call out by individual, fawn, doe, buck, and that will be a kind of a repetitive process that happens for each group of deer that we see.
Get does, 26, 2 does, make one of those a young buck. We're going towards that, a little more open. Yearling, doe, doe, young buck, doe, 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 another doe.
The information that we're gathering helps us to estimate the sex and age ratios, which in turn help us to allocate licenses for the number of bucks that we want to see harvested and the number of does that we want to see harvested or not harvested in order to reach our long-term population goals. Well, there's multiple biologists throughout the state that are doing the same type of work, and we have two different helicopters working in the northwest region. Statewide, we've got 4 different helicopters working. It's a great way to assess in a short amount of time the health of our deer herd, the distribution of our deer herd, get a general idea on numbers based on densities in different areas. Because when you have a history of flying these same areas throughout multiple years, you're able to kind of make that assessment. I love working with mule deer. Flying around in a helicopter is a lot of fun, and it's a great way to see the countryside, because the scenery is always changing as you move along, and the diversity of wildlife that you're able to see is pretty spectacular. I mean, you see everything from small predators like red fox and coyotes to on occasion a mountain lion, bobcats, and then you also see deer. And I mean, sometimes you get to see really big deer, and that's a lot of fun. Seeing those and seeing all the fawns out there too to be recruited into the population is also a great thing, because that's what we're counting on to grow our deer populations. This will help inform our management process for deer. It's really an important part of what we do on an annual basis in order to monitor those deer herds.